Okay, hello everybody. Hello, Stephanie. I wish you can catch up this video as you did last time. We are also on YouTube. Let me pass you YouTube as well. So you can either join my personal Zoom meeting so we can chat or just watch it on YouTube. See, I go to my channel, YouTube/. I think I'm live there, so I'm going to send a link. Share link. Okay, so sending you. Okay, so last time we did a small seal. It's as small as this one, it's 1/2 inch, and you can see the printout. If you paint like this size, you need to sign even smaller than this, I think. So that means the, you know, it will match roughly the size of the character. So if you can sign just, you know, about 1/2 of this size, it should be okay. Just use a smaller brush, and because I switched the preference from the two designs, I decided to carve this one for you, and thank you for taking my offer. So you get 2 seals, 1/2 inch and 1¾ inch. So when you paint larger painting, you can sign in this size and use this seal. You will see it will be perfectly matched. This one can also do, you know, because the red stamp has much weight. Even if it's small, it can balance large characters like this size. For those who just watched this video, the name is derived from both the meaning and how to say. Yeah, basically we have to recreate your Chinese name. And Stephanie Bell is she's in my online class, and we had this discussion in the classroom as to what to translate. So I translated last name Zhong, meaning Bell, which is happened to be a Chinese feminine name, and she likes the good meaning words like calm or peace, name or just serene, and water. The peaceful water is the name she wants, the Ling Shui, Zhong Ling Shui. Let me share a screen so you can see our online class look like. We have a year-round pre-recorded online class, so you can access anytime, 7 days a week, 24 hours, from anyone. You can watch the recorded video. So see, so she has joined maybe for a couple of months. She has taken number 1, 2, 3 class plan. I think the Zoom just crashed. All right, so we're back. The Zoom just crashed. Anyway, let me do it one more time. So this is the calligraphy class with Victoria. And let's go back to lesson one. You start from orchid, right? Let me see, how did you do? And here's Stephanie's first assignment. She did a very good job. The three basic strokes. And this part could be, it's too loose, could be tightened. This is a little better, so all the roots pointing to the same center, you may call it. We call it fish heads seeking the same food in classical teaching books. That's the chicken. It just takes more practice. Yeah, this carries pretty well. So you're working on noun. Next is, yeah, I see you have good control of the moisture of water on rice paper, which is a talent, I will say. You just need a little more details, like the wings are missing on these birds, otherwise it would be perfect. Okay. Your flowers looks good. Yeah, composition goes pretty well. This signature should be a little lower, even on this side. And this bird neck is a little too expanded. It should be a little narrower. Yeah, this leg, this feet could be a little defined. Very good. Well, I can annotate actually if you just. Yeah, just cut this piece off will be good. Just take this extra part. The feet looks like this in the side view. This wing, this is the front. The tail could be a little longer in the center. These are just small things you need to be more careful. These two dots could be a little expanded into lines, maybe. The crossing, the branches are good. The, you know, the triangular or diamond shape, the negative space, that's what we're looking for. Oops. I hope you can catch up me online so I can show you the carving process and answer any questions you might have. Okay, I'm going to do this seal again. So you already learned how to write the name. I skipped that part. I went directly to carving this seal now. These two designs are quite close. That's why I got confused last time when I make the when I prepared the printout for the transfer. So, but it's a good idea to have both designs on different size. Okay, so I'm going to do the margin first, just test the stone, cut out this edge. I hold the knife this way. Just cut out the edge and the corner, make it look older, look like antique. In art, we call this antiquarianism. It's a style. Just like you wash the jeans, you wash out jeans, vintage kind of style in fashion. And you worn, look, make it look worn, even with holes, right? And we chip the edge, so just make it looks. It used to be the authenticity mark, so you chip randomly, which makes it impossible to duplicate. So you can use it as your signature in banks. So not anymore in practice, but we still appreciate that kind of chipping. Make the corner look like an old, very old TV monitor in the 50s, maybe. So it's kind of old. Not square. Not square, not round. This is in carving style. That's what Stephanie prefers. It gives you more red. To make a stroke look smooth, I do two cuts, so the knife stays in the center of the stroke. Okay, let me just turn off all the windows, see if it helps. I think it's on and off. It is for some reason. So I will just keep doing this just for the record. Just sorry if it's interrupt. Wish I can. Let me just make a recording so we'll upload it later. So this is the first character that was different from the previous design. So this is slightly different variational form of the same character, Zhong or Bei. Thank you. Okay, the second character is a new or he's four. Come for or Serene. Serene. It's the roof. Thank you. All right, it's almost done. So just fine tuning some strokes. I can see I'm not even. I just make them look even. Just turn off the light, maybe to blur. Okay, now you can see better. It's both just like I do this. So basically, we have got it all. Just the tip of some strokes are too sharp. I want to round it up a little bit. We try to hide the tip of stroke, just like a calligraphy, we always do that. Make it round instead of sharp or squarish, it's sticking out. Just make it more smooth. Corners of the ending of strokes are most important. You try to duplicate the reproduce the bronze seal in using different materials, a stone, a soapstone to simulate bronze casted seal. Okay. Okay, I'm going to dust it off and make an imprint and close the window. I'll just wash it. Well, I just dry it with paper towel, a tissue. And we need a rubber net, pad under it, because this is hard, not like a rubber stamp. We need the rubber underneath it. Okay. This is the silk, not silk, the paste with a kind of fiber made of reed, black fiber, kind of plant reed flag. It's a paste and it's some oil-based ink. Okay. Hope it will come out. Okay. Okay, take it slowly and up straight. Okay. And look like I have an extra margin to take off. So when I carve the rim, the slope is not too deep, it's you know, steep. So we need to take care of that. But the stroke looks close, very close. Just a little bit adjustment. Some strokes need to be broadened still. So just holding hand. Go off and on all the time. It just happens sometimes. We have to live with that. That's that. Okay. Let me finish this. Anyway. Okay, I think we'll be finished in this clip. Let me take another shot. Yeah, that's about it. Okay, I'm going to make an official imprint. And that's it. One last thing is this could be a little longer. Okay. One last thing. This is true. Yes. Perfect. I like it. And this tool is a must. You can see to make it smooth and easy to load. I'll just do this stir. It comes with the set of ink paste, a high quality set. You can also get buy this from our website. We still have a few, I think. Okay. Let me take an imprint in my collection book. And I'll put it together with the one we did yesterday. Yeah, here. And you can see the size difference and a little bit different in style. Mainly with the first character on the right, the character for Bale. Yeah. See, much bigger, huh? So half inch and a 3/4 inch. We can go even bigger to 1 inch. That would be for quite large paintings. So the character goes with the size of the seal. And generally speaking, you use smaller seal on landscape without destroying the scale of the scenery. And this good for flower and birds painting. Okay. Thanks for watching. I'm going to put the signature on the left side so you will know the orientation. Wait, my signature there should be on the left side. If you like to order yours, please check blueheronarts.com for details. And to sign up for my online class, I'll put a link there at ChineseBrushPainting.ning.com. We will help you get your name translation and have the design for your name to sign. Okay, bye bye now. Until next time, bye bye.